हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम संपदा कुलकर्णी वेलकम्स यू इन माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स। इन दिस वीडियो सीरीज आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू ट्री डेटा स्ट्रक्चर। बिफोर मूविंग टू द कंटेंट आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू टू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स एंड कीप द बेल रिंगिंग। नाउ लेट्स सी व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ ट्री ट्रैवर्सल, व्हाट डिफरेंट ट्री ट्रैवर्सल टेक्निक्स आर देयर and how they are useful to traverse the tree. So basically there are two traversal techniques. They are DFS and BFS. DFS stands for depth first traversal technique and BFS stands for breadth first traversal technique. First of all we will see what different ways in which we can traverse a tree according to depth of the tree. They are pre-order, in-order and post-order traversal. All these three different traversal techniques or the ways in which we can traverse a tree are mainly depend on the position of a root node. I have already explained all these things in detail in my previous videos. For your reference, I am providing a shortcut link in this write-up corner. If you want to know more about these different traversal techniques, then please go through the video and then you can resume back this current video. Next is breadth first traversal. In breadth first traversal technique, the tree is traversed according to level. That's why it is also called as level order traversal. In this video, I am focusing on the in order traversal technique. How to traverse a tree in order, that I am going to focus in this video session. So in order traversal, where this is the binary tree traversal and where we supposed to follow the sequence left root node and right. So here you can see that the position of root node is in between, so that's why the name of this traversal technique is in order traversal. First of all, I would like to explain all these things with the help of this simple example. Here a root node is there, its left child and its right child is there. How to traverse this tree in order, that I am going to explain you in this slide. So as all of us are knowing, this is the in order traversal where it follows the sequence left root node and right, the same sequence we supposed to follow. So first of all, let's start with a left child. Starting from a root node, we will check whether it is having a left child. Yes, it is having a left child, so that's why I traverse a left child. Then move back to the root node. Here you can see that I am going to move back to the root node. How to move back to the root node? Because this is a tree data structure, and if you are knowing the concept of tree data structure, there is no any backlink is available from the lower level to the higher level or to the previous level, or from child to parent, there is no any link is available. So this how we can do. So this we are going to do with the help of different algorithms, that I'm coming back to this particular point in the next slide. You just keep in mind that we are going to discuss about this particular issue. So now let's complete the in order traversal. So now after returning back to the root node, our next step is to traverse the root node. So here I am traversing a root node, and at the end my last option, last choice is to go to the right child. So now let's moving to the right child. A's right child is C, so that's why I am displaying it. So in this way, the in order traversal of the given binary tree is B, A, C. Here you can see that left child is B, root node is A and its right child is C. So in this way we can traverse the tree. So now here what we supposed to do, I'm helping you to go forward for the this question, where how to return back to the previous node. So my question is how to return back to the previous level. So we supposed to find out a solution for that. So we are having a solution with us is nothing but recursive and non-recursive algorithms. As I explained previously, that we are going to go forward for the solution how to return back to the previous node. So we are having a two solution with us, from which the first one is recursive algorithm, the another one is non-recursive algorithm. I have already explained the first solution, that is recursive algorithm, and for your reference, again I am providing you a shortcut link in this write-up corner, where two separate examples I have already explained how to traverse a tree recursively in order way. And here I am focusing on the concept where non-recursive algorithms, how the non-recursive algorithm will work to give us a solution to traverse a tree in order, that I am going to explain you in this current video. So in this video my topic is non-recursive in order binary tree traversal. This I am going to explain you, where algorithm I am going to explain you basically what is the non-recursive algorithm to traverse a tree, binary tree in order. So now let's move forward for the non-recursive algorithm. Here I have already given a non-recursive algorithm which is for in order, and I am passing a root node to this algorithm or to this function. There are five different steps in which I am going to explain you all the steps one by one, and in the next slide I am going to explain you it with the help of example by dry running the code. So first step is to create a stack of data type structure node. After creating a stack, why to use a stack? Stack is a data structure which is last in first out, and this is the property that we are going to use to return back from the lower level to the higher level. So if you want to know more about the stack data structure for the same as well, I am providing you a shortcut link in this write-up corner, is nothing but stack data structure. So I assume that all of you are knowing the concept of stack data structure. And now my step number 2 is to initialize a current node. This is a variable I am going to use in throughout my function, that is current node. And in this step I am initializing this current node to the root. After initializing current node to the root, we supposed to follow these two steps, that is 3.1 and 3.2. With the do while loop, we have to do both the steps till or while my current node is not equal to null. So initially we supposed to go to the function, do while loop, where we have to push the current node onto the stack. Why supposed to use do while loop? Because do while loop is unconditional, means for the firstly we are not going to check any condition. Once it will get executed, we are going to check the condition whether the current node is not null. If it is not null, then we are going to execute both the steps again, and that both the steps will get executed till my current node is not equal to null. So now let's start with a root node where root is not null. So I am going to push this current node onto the stack. And after this, we are going to set the current node equal to whatever we have pushed onto the stack, its left child. The left child of a current node that I am going to assign or making as a new current node. This I am going to perform repeatedly because this is the in order traversal and we supposed to traverse the left subtree first. So that's why I will go down to the left subtree of my tree till it is not going to become null. Once it is null, I will go forward for the next step. Again in the next step, I am going to check whether it is null or not. If it is null, then and then only, and one more condition we are going to check, whether my stack is not empty. If both the conditions are true, that is my current node is null and my stack is not empty, then my first step is to pop the node from the stack and display it. Whatever top of the stack is there, whatever from the content of the stack, the top of the stack will get popped from the stack and it will display it. Here you can see that here we have done with the left. Now it's turn to display the root node, and now the next thing is we are moving to the right, as our sequence is left, root node and right in order. So my next step is again we are going to update the current node by the right child of the popped item. Whatever popped element is there, its right child we supposed to assign as a current node, we supposed to use as a current node, and we are going to return back to the step number 3 again to check whether my current node is not null. Now my current node is nothing but whatever I have popped in the previous step, its right child, and if it is not null, we again supposed to move to the left of that right child, and for that we are going to execute this while loop again till my current node is not equal to null. And at the end, all these things are going to be happen in hand. The first while is for not null, and the another while is for null condition along with the stack is not empty. And if this is the condition, either condition is false, that is if current node is null and my stack is empty, then we supposed to indicate that we have done with the in order traversal. I know it is difficult to understand theoretically. Now I am going to explain you the same algorithm practically by dry running the code, dry running the algorithm with the one example, a simple example in this video. So now the same algorithm I have written over here for your reference, and now let's start with the execution. So very first step is to create the stack. Before creating the stack, here this is the area where I am going to display you the result of the in order traversal. So now first of all create a stack. So I have created a stack. After that, second step is to initialize the current node as a root node. So here you can see that my current node is equal to root is equal to A, because my root is nothing but node A. So that's why I have initialized it to A. After this, what is my next step? Next step is current node is not equal to null. My condition is true. It means that I have to push this current node onto the stack. So now let's push A onto the stack. So I have pushed it. Now let's move to the next step is whatever the left child of a current node is there, that I am going to reinitialize as the current node. So I am updating my current node with the left child of current node. So now here my current node is A's left child is nothing but B. Here you can see that the left child of A is nothing but B. So that's why this B, a new value is updated into the current node. So now my current node, new current node is nothing but B. Now let's move back to the while where whether my current node is not equal to null, the condition is true. So it will enter into the while loop, and my first step is to push the current node onto the stack. So here you can see that I have pushed B onto the stack. Now again I am updating the current node with whatever the left child is present of the current node is assigned with the new current node. So what is the left child of B? Its left child is null. So that's why now my updated current node is nothing but null. Now let me know whether this condition will be true or false. Yes, this condition will be false, because now my current node is equal to null. So it will get exited from this while loop and it will enter into the fourth step. Now fourth step is current node is null and my stack is not empty. Both the conditions are true. Here you can see that current node is null and stack is not empty. It is having some elements. So that's why both conditions are true. It will enter into the while loop and it will pop the top of the stack and it will display it. So which one is the element present at the top of the stack is nothing but B. So now let's pop B and display it. Here you can see that I have displayed B onto the result, that is in order traversal. Now the next one is again we are going to update the current node by what we have done with its left, we have done with a root node and now we are going for a right of a popped item. So which one is the popped item? It is B. Here you can see that B's right child is null. So now what will be my current node? Updated value in current node will be null. Here you can see that my updated current node will be null. After this, where we need to go? We need to go back to the step number 3. Whether my condition will be true or false? The condition is false because it is null. Again, it will return back to step number 4. Let's check whether my current node is null and my stack is not empty. Yes, both the conditions are true. That's why pop top of the stack and displayed. So now what I will pop now? I'll pop A from a stack and here I'm popping it. And here you can see that I'm displaying it. After displaying it, our next step is again to update the value of current node by putting the right child of the popped item into the current node. So here you can see that A is my popped item and its right child is C. So now I am updating a current node, A's right child equal to C, that I am going to assign to the current node. So updated value in my current node is nothing but C. Now next step is go back to the step number 3. I'll return back to step number 3 to check whether my condition is true or not. Yes, my condition is true because my current node is having value C, which is not equal to null. Again enter and push it onto the stack. So now let's push C onto the stack. After that, again update the current node by the left child of a current node. So my updated value in current node will be null. Again this condition is going to false. And I go for a step number 4 or a next step where my current node is null and my stack is not empty. Both the conditions are true. Pop top of the stack and display it. So what is there in top of the stack? It is C. Pop it from a stack and here display it. So I have displayed C. Go for a next step, that is update the value of current node by right child of a popped item. Which one is the popped item? It is C. C's right child is nothing but null. So here you can see that current node is updated with the value null. Again go to step number 3. Let's go back to step number 3. This condition is false. The current node is null. Let's go for a step 4. Here you can see that current node is null but my stack is empty now. There is no any data available in my stack. So that's why this condition is false, and if either condition is false, this will not enter into the loop and it will go for a next step. And here you can see that if my current node is null and my stack is empty, then we are done. And here you can see that this is nothing but the in order traversal of a given tree, that is B, A, C. I hope you must have understood what I want to explain in this in order traversal with the help of non-recursive algorithm. So thank you dear friends for listening and watching my video. Please do not forget to give the comment. Here I am providing you a shortcut link for the subscription of my channel. If you have not subscribed my channel yet, then please do subscribe my channel Tech Talks. Along with this, I am providing you a shortcut link for a playlist of this video series as well as a new video. I am going to give a shortcut link over here. Thank you and stay tuned with Tech Talks. Thank you.